Ja, habe ich schon alles
Haben wir schon in die
gezeigt.
Kamera gezeigt. All right, we have to recalibrate everything and
more people watching online. I mean, after this game, we have the last three games of this Champions Cup. The third place, Orcas Flipper, Castores Akaren for the first and the second place in the women's side, and then Molde Bamberg.
So back in the game here, Firenze against Barcelona, Firenze in white, Barcelona in blue. Champions Cup 2016 here in Berlin. We have now Barcelona attacking
we have
heavily.
Like cartoon voices? What do you mean? Oh, okay. We need to recalibrate the sound.
Please keep us posted. We had a power shortage and probably the cartoon voices the Disney voices came from the power shortage before it blacked out.
Smart.
So let's stay in the game. Firenze tries now to secure their lead with 1-0. But there's a four-checking classified in the middle of the pool. A Barcelona player just got hold of the ball, and we have a cluster in the middle on the surface, recalibrating the screen for you. Yeah, we are too much. I hope you can hear us better now. Okay, there was a call from the referee.
So we're working on the sound, so we can return to our normal voices.
Okay, we sound funny. That's really good.
Minions transmitting. Okay. Yeah, I mean, apparently
there is the referees are talking to the team captains. Okay. Interesting, because it's some minutes. So we don't know what they discuss. So tell us if you can hear us properly again. I can do my funny voice.
No, I don't. Then it's even higher pitch.
This is your funny voice.
Hold on, Jörg, I have to pull up the volume.
This is your funny voice?
No, this was a funny sound.
Maybe he should not ask the world if this is funny.
No, I don't have to ask. I know it is funny.
Well, everyone is laughing, so we're happy that you're having a good time. The techniques are trying to recover our former
okay,
voices.
So as long as you understand us and you think it's Goofy and Mickey Mouse talking, that's fine for us.
So 5-0 for Firenze, and 5-0? 1-0, sorry. That was a really surprise attack, because Barcelona had been dominating the first half of the.
Yeah, my guess would have been this game belongs to Barcelona, and it's 20 seconds left if the
Firenze
clock is
recover,
right.
Yes, Firenze recover, and
here Firenze, we have a power move from Firenze. Wow! Was this? Yeah, that was legit. Wow!
Wow.
There was a power swim. Well, you have the scene when the losing team has to throw in all their players. We saw that in which game game Castores against Langen, probably when they had a counter attack, the Firenze swimmer just swam through with a fast break, and
2-0 for Firenze.
No,
no
other player. 2-0, yeah, 2-0.
So that means that Firenze is on the 11th place. And
you really have fun.
Yeah.
You really have fun with our voices here.
Please record it and send it to us. what happened. There was a power shortage, and now the system got a little bit...
Yeah, we were sitting from one second to the other. We were sitting in the dark in this bunker here. Quite scary. I was clinging to Jörg. He was holding me and protected me because it was dark and I was afraid.
The settings, I mean, got all kind of...
Wait for it.
We should think about the organization and the commentary.
Yes.
Maybe 3 days is much too long for Rolf.
It's not enough. I'm a robot.
Yeah, well, you sound... I think we really sound like robots right now.
Okay, next game coming up.
Party. Yeah, well...
It's another very interesting.
We sound like Mickey Mouse. Yeah. I think we more or less
like the Minion.
We feel goofy. We feel like
yes,
Mickey Mouse.
I do. So this will be a fast game. We will see. That's for sure.
Orcas against Flipper, and this is for the third place for the men in this cup, and my guess goes to Orcas. What do you say, Rob?
Yeah, well, the game against Molde was
3-0 Orcas.
Yeah, I think also.
Yeah, yeah. We no should. No, question. Yeah,
do you think we should do a YouTube channel together? Just Wolf and Jörg and Wolf.
Yeah, I'm in.
That would be super successful, and we invest all the money we make with the advertising, with the clicks, with the millions of clicks we have worldwide. We're gonna finance underwater rugby in Germany.
Okay, I'm in.
Okay, wait, let's do it. People will love it.
you know, you have to understand, I'm a serious part here.
Yeah, I know. I'm joking, but I'm deadly serious.
No, this YouTube, I will be in, so no problem about that.
Okay.
So, but during the commentary, when we see Lorena as experienced player, successful.
Beautiful.
Yeah. Beautiful looking.
Beautiful looking.
So, but that's not a selection option in a team in Germany.
No.
It helps, but it's not.
Look, Steffi is so nice.
I'm wondering always, I'm always thinking or joking in the team saying, hey, we should do the two teams, one for the calendar and one for the playing.
This is so macho.
We have a lot of beautiful girls on the team.
All girls are beautiful.
Yeah, so many friends.
All girls are beautiful.
So, let's see. What was the score? 2-0 for Firenze.
Yeah.
Firenze really
surprising. Really a big surprise. If you watch the game against Barcelona, Firenze upped their game, and it was really like like Gabriele said to Lorena, the first half wasn't good for Firenze, but the second half definitely belonged to Firenze. They scored in the first seconds almost in the last seconds. So it was well fought, well done, and happy for Firenze.
So far, what the position? What we're waiting for the games between Orcas and Flipper to start?
Well, my guess is 2-1, probably.
Okay.
I think Flipper is good enough as a team to score against the Orcas. Here we go. We start almost. Here we go. This is one of the exciting games. We saw a lot of exciting games, especially the Egge game today. But now we have Orcas against Flipper. Flipper, EuroLeague trained Orcas, one of the top teams on the world. So this will be interesting. And call from the referee. This is funny. The referee with his bottle was standing on the ground, and the player, I think it was Samuel, was standing next to him on the ground of the pool, on the bottom of the pool, looking at him and shaking his head. Quite funny. Okay, we have an attack, free throw from Flipper against the Orcas, and we have an attack of Flipper in the direction of the Orca basket, but the forechecking of the Orcas, as we know, is quite fast, and
let's see, it's more of a speed game against a more of a strength game from Flipper. I mean, the orcas play the ball a little bit more open, a little bit more fast.
Well, the Flipper know how to play rough at the basket, and they have to interrupt the fast game playing of the orcas. And here we go. We are already at the basket of a Flipper from the close side, an attack on the close side. But the Flipper player recovers the ball and tries to break free, but is stopped by the forechecking of the orcas. And
yeah, they're trying to run down, but the techniques are working on it. And I mean, probably takes a little while. So we.
Well, Maria, all this is for free, and all this is done by ourselves. So sorry it didn't work out, but that's how it is.
So we have a Flipper player fighting fierce with an Orca player trying to recover the ball. But
and the ball is outside the playing area,
so
free throw against Orcas. The result in the game, Barcelona against Firenze, was 2-0 for Firenze. Firenze did win.
All right, so we have a free throw against Orcas, and Flipper now is starting to go toward the basket, but it's been intercepted by one of the four checkers of Orcas.
As if Flipper tries to take out the speed of the game and play it more safe, and don't give the Orcas the possibility to build up their high speed swarming game.
Yeah.
So it's really I don't see it. Don't see quite well with the hand camera and with the bubbles from people.
Now they're coming over the close corner, but the Orcas is well in position and they are very good at forechecking.
We have the clinging, the clustering together as soon as the Flipper players come too close to the basket of the Orcas, and the Flipper players are tackled away, and this is call from the referees. This is a surprising slow game and power move game here.
There's a free throw for Flipper in the 3 meter line.
The second free throw, and it looks like the Orcas cannot unfold as the way as we know them.
Yes, it's taking them a little bit long to recover the ball and to swim free. But probably, you think that they are tired from the game from yesterday?
Who, Orca or no?
Orca.
I think it's.
They have a very great condition, but
No. I totally think it's the will of Flipper here to break the speed and the team play of the Orcas. They want to inhibit it, the swarming, which we see now. This is the power break we are used from the Orcas, and this is what Flipper tried to prevent, and they did quite well. So now we are on the basket of Flipper, and the Orcas can build up their attack pattern and build up the machine they have. But these clustering, these stopping of the game prevents the Orca game and stops them.
Yeah,
and
I mean, Orca is good in the speed and swimming, they can swim a lot, but in the strength game, this is a disadvantage for them, and Flipper is more used to, you know, European. I mean, they can play both. They can be also in a speed, but they hold the ball much secure than Orcas. Orcas played very, very open.
Call from the referee.
This is really not working in their favor right now. They cannot break the strength game that Flipper is doing with the holding of the ball and fighting.
I think the idea of Flipper is here to give the orcas the impression the game is slowing down, and then when the orcas are confused about what how to react to it, Flipper will change the gears and go into attack mode.
It's going. I mean, we don't see a lot of orca players under water, and this is what is killing them, because normally we know that they go 2-3 and they'll double pass, they go they do double passes and they keep passing the ball very fast. But right now, in the middle of the field, there was always one player holding the ball and just one other player that would be able to get the pass, and that's that makes it too slow, and then Flipper can do it with and stop the game. They need to start, you know, swimming a little bit more. We don't see any swimming.
Here the same scene. Every interruption works for Flipper in this case, because the interrupted game doesn't allow the orcas to build up their fast, high-speed ball passing, swarming technique. And it looks like orcas don't have a remedy against it. They're not really confused, but they only react to what Flipper is is making the call in this game. And they right here. Do you see it again? They stop the game of the orcas, and
now they're in the surface.
Constant interruption.
And costing a lot of air of the orca players.
Call from the referee on the surface. Chief referee here.
So now we're waiting for a free throw against Flipper, and let's see if they can execute. I mean, the forechecking of Flipper is great. You see, that's what I mean. The orca player did not have the chance to pass the ball because the mates are not diving. I'm a bit surprised. Normally, we're used to see a lot of underwater time, and
then
look, they're all in the surface.
But probably it is because they didn't find the rhythm in this interrupted game, in this interrupted Flipper game.
But to start the rhythm, they need to break the circle, and to break the circle of strength that Flipper is doing, they need to start diving in.
Here the scene is super uncommon for orcas. There was no second player coming down. An orca, seeing an orca player waiting for his teammates to appear, is doesn't happen very often. So this is interesting, and orcas are really out of their game. Look at this. There was an orca player throwing down the ball to the bottom of the pool because there was no other player he could pass to. So.
Colombia, que están mirando el partido de Orcas por el tercer puesto, estamos sorprendidos porque Orcas no puede establecer el tipo de juego que normalmente hacen, nadando mucho, ofreciéndose debajo del agua. Y bueno, ahora tenemos uno de los chicos de Orcas que ha robado la portería de Flipper, pero Flipper está haciendo muy buen trabajo de chequeando y recuperando el balón, haciendo un trabajo de fuerza, y no sé por qué los chicos de Orcas están tanto en la superficie, o sea, no logran estar, normalmente uno está acostumbrado a tener a 2, 3, 4. Está la sensación de que tienen 10 jugadores bajo el agua y ahora los vemos solos atacando por ahí de a dos. Estoy sorprendida, no quiero creer que tengan un problema de condición, porque la verdad que entrenan mucho, así que no sé, a ver si es que Flipper está teniendo éxito en la táctica de fuerza que está usando para romper el juego de velocidad de Orcas. Yeah, I was saying the same Spanish.
Very interesting and a good example for how you can impose your plans on another team. Again, also these referee interruptions work for Flipper. It's a non-working game. It's a dysfunctional game. Here what we see, and this is definitely not in favor of Orcas. They're confused, and
I think they make always a mistake. They try to steal the goalie position. Again, the goalie position is taken, and that's a good chance. And goal
for Orcas, and this time worked. But it's mostly exception than the rule. We've seen it many times.
I think
it was 20 times.
The universe was reacting to Jörg, because when he said they were always stealing the goalie position, the universe said, Jörg, I'll show you different. Bam.
No, but really...
frankly speaking, the Orcas not controlling the game.
No, not at all.
That was a lucky punch.
I think if they want to win the game, they have to button time, much more button time.
But it's
Flipper reacts positively.
But also
when it's starting that this is they want to steal the goalie position, Flipper has to react there more consequently. So there were four or six times Orca player laying on the door on the goal. So sooner or later this will not work out.
True.
What we just saw.
But I think what Orcas needed was one step in their direction. So okay, now they can refocus. They scored. They have the time and the timeout. And now they know what Flipper is doing. And let's see how they react in this.
I think it will be now become more physical.
Yes, me
game.
Too. Yeah.
And that will be, of course, it's an underwater rugby. It's a physical game. It's a touching game, but it will more tough, I think, the second half.
Yeah.
Because now Flipper cannot only wait and interrupt, they have to work hard. And here we go, they are already attacking the Orca basket, and they are tackled away. Four players are pushing their two Flipper players, two Orca players, pushing each other.
And now we can see a little bit more, but again, they're missing the play position. They're taking too long.
It's something we don't see very often with the Orca game. They are searching for pass stations to get rid of the ball, and they are under attack, and they don't have another teammate waiting to accept the ball. So, interesting call from the referee, and free throw against Orca. Yes.
Pues muy bien, o sea, los chicos de Orcas han podido hacer un gol cuando el portero de Flipper se descuidó, robaron la portería, tenían un tiro libre y la verdad que pudieron llegar a tiempo y ejecutar el gol, a pesar de que casi no estuvieron dominando el primer tiempo y Flipper estaba teniendo la posición del balón o por lo menos rompiendo la táctica de nado rápido de Orcas. Ahora estamos viendo que se están recuperando un poco y están pudiendo jugar el juego de ellos, que es mucho nado, mucho movimiento bajo el agua. Y a ver si Flipper puede continuar disrumpiendo la táctica o si Orcas logra imponer su táctica de juego.
Yes, I agree with Jörg and with Anya in the chat. It will be more physical now, mostly from the Flipper side. Orcas don't need the physical game, but it works against them if they have to, because they are swimmers, they are fast swimmers. They try to build up their attack patterns by swimming, by weaving fast ball passing and swarming. And if Flipper succeeds in destroying this pattern and going in physically, they will have an advantage in confusing the Orcas like they did in the first 6 minutes.
Yes,
so
I mean
we
they
have
were very successful what they were doing.
Yeah,
I mean,
they
really
were.
Surprised.
But in the end, they caught a goal. So
counter-attack, and the Orca goalie Barry made it. And now it's a little bit of unrest there at the basket of Orcas. But it looks like they are being able to defend.
54 seconds, 50 seconds left. This is not a nice game. We saw better games today as from the viewpoint
flow
of a watcher.
For
watcher here in the live stream, for the cameras. This is not a beautiful game. This is a staccato back and forth stop game, and it's not nice to watch, and it is exhausting, but it's bodily hurting. You see, it's a lot of physical contact. And we're now at the basket of Flipper, and there's another tackle. And the cluster coming up to the surface, 10 seconds left. That's the first round, and Flipper player is going for a counterattack. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
First half time, 15 minutes gone, 1-0 for Orcas.
I wonder what conclusion the Orcas will take out of this first round, if they will rethink what they can do, if it's even possible to rethink it and to adapt to the strategy of Flipper of interrupting the game of the Orcas. Well, Carl, yes, it's beautiful from the point of Flipper, from compared to what we've seen early on. For example, it was Ege against Finland. That, in my opinion, to watch, that was a beautiful game.
Even Langen against Akaren was great to watch.
Yeah, yeah, the both fun teams with a lot of swimming, forechecking, movement, and not so many breakups.
The Czech against Malmo as well was really had a lot of flow, but this one is a bit more tight. Let's see if Flipper can start playing the tactic in the second half that they were doing in the first half. I think that it will depend on that, but right now if Orca has done one goal, they will defend. We saw they are really good defenders yesterday against Molde. It was amazing. They just were almost half an hour or 20 minutes defending at their basket almost non-stop, because Molde was in possession of the ball almost 80% of the game. So now it's a tough half of a time for Flipper. If they want to recover, they will have to do a lot of more pressure than they have been doing.
I'm wondering if it's possible for Orcas to outswim Flipper's destructive game-stopping idea of imposing their will on the game of the Orcas. So I'm curious about the second half. Orcas leading, but that's no security. The Flipper players are very able to score and even to win. We have a new.
We have a plan. So
this
that
is becoming our home.
Yeah, but we are going
getting more cozy.
Yeah.
I think they're preparing for our YouTube channel, Jörg.
Okay.
Jörg, is ready?
I'm happy. The YouTube channel will. I can stop working.
We can put displays on the.
If we are successful,
yeah.
You mean?
Yeah.
Okay. But we will have to live and stay here in this bunker.
In this bunker?
Oh yes, you with me.
Yeah, just we enter some sofa.
Yes, a sofa would be nice.
Okay. Is the sound a little bit better, or do we still sound like minions?
I am a minion.
You look like a minion.
You have the blue eyes. Sí, Flipper tiene que ahora empezar a presionar, porque si no, o sea, vimos ayer que Molde presionó durante 20 minutos constantemente y no lograron meterle un gol a Orcas, y Flipper no ha hecho, o sea, casi ni una quinta parte de esa presión que tuvo Molde. Entonces tienen que, no sé, ver si pueden establecer de nuevo la táctica de romperle la velocidad, el juego veloz a Orcas, y ver si con un poco de fuerza pueden presionar. Pero yo, pensando en el juego de ayer, lo veo difícil. Si Orcas sigue concentrado en el juego y no comete errores.
So we get even more flowers. It's getting cozy in here. Flowers, we got a little heating, we have coffee. I feel home.
Really?
Yes, I do. It feels. I feel, yes.
Okay, a little better, Carl, thank you.
Okay, so I can do my cartoon voice now. Yeah, the funny thing is, after 3 days wearing these earphones, your ears start to hurt. So being a professional commentator and doing this every day, you have to have really strong ears. Pardon me? Yes. So, yes, please keep us... Ow. Yeah, Lorena's ears are hurting. Okay, we're back in the game. The game started already. 10 seconds already over. Orcas are now on the left side and Flipper is on the right side. And here Orcas try to outswim Flipper, which is quite difficult because every station is protected and marked by Flipper players. But now they reach the basket of Flipper and are on the closed corner side of the Flipper basket. And now let's see if Orca read the game purpose of Flipper right, and they find a remedy against this imposing game of Flipper. But like before, we have it looks like there's a problem with the Orcas. The bottom time of the Orcas is not what we are used to see from them, and now there's a heavy fighting back and forth around the basket of Flipper for domination of the ball. We are in the half now, in the half of the pool. Ball is dropping down, and there's a call from the referee. I don't see it holding without ball. Free throw against Orcas.
Yeah.
So this is Flipper in the tag now. Coming in from the close side, from the wall, and stopped, tackled up to the surface. Another Flipper player trying it from above, throwing it to the open side where another Flipper is already waiting, but he has a defender in front of him, and an attacker is tackling away, but there's the second and the third Flipper player coming from the open side, and all three of them are tackled to the surface. They put really hard pressure, physical hard pressure. It's a one-on-one fight. This is this dog fighting around the basket, which is quite exhausting.
Flipper just recovered the ball, and now they're trying to start the attack. We can't see where is the ball. Oh, there it is.
So Flipper is in ball possession, coming on in the middle of the pool. We have a player taking the defender position, trying to block and open a side for his teammates, but they lost the ball, pushed to the middle of the pool, and here Orcas succeeded in recovering the ball. There was a call from the referee.
But I can't see what's...
It's a free throw against Flipper, and a chance for Orcas. And Orcas are leading 1-0 here.
Yeah, and... it's a little bit a slower game that we are used to.
But it's
more physical. But even yesterday when we saw Molde against Orcas, it was very physical, but it was so much faster. Don't
yes,
you think?
It was a much faster game, and all these interruptions work in favor of Flipper and the plan of Flipper to interrupt this fast swimming and passing game of Orcas. Now we have an Orca player on the open side, second one. He's playing to his teammate in the inside of the pool. He's swimming around the pool, losing the ball in this skirmish under the basket. and still ball in Orca possession, and there are at the wall a little bit inside of the pool on the surface waiting, and now the time is ticking. We have a little bit more than 10 minutes left and the time is working.
Still it's possible for Flipper to score, but they need to start getting out of their area and attacking in waves, because Orcas need a lot of pressure to leave an opening in their defense. And right now you see that now it's Orca games. What we are seeing in the first half, it was Flipper games. It's completely disrupting the game of Orcas, but now Orcas could reestablish a little bit their game, and they're coming and passing the ball and swimming around in the typical Colombia style that we know. They don't tend to use the triangle attack. I mean, what we used normally tend to use in Europe, which means, you know, right, left, we have a player, then in the middle of the basket a little bit away, you have the normally the goalkeeper that does the distribution of the ball. They tend to swim a lot more from with the ball. Now we have an Orca attacker on top of the goalie from Flipper. The goalie from Flipper just recovered the ball, is trying to start a counter attack, and we have the goalkeeper against and that was quite a kick, and that's Negreson with a penalty. I mean, that was a kick in the face of the Flipper attacker, and let's see. I can't see what the referee's decision. It's timeout, and I didn't see what was the decision on that fault, or is it just going to be a free throw? Because it was one attacker against one goalkeeper. So we see their teams now catching a breath, discussing, you know, what they can do better, what it's not working. And they have about 6 or 5 minutes left. So still, well, not a bit less, I mean, a bit more, it's about 9 minutes left, sorry. So still enough time to maybe change the score for Flipper. Still everything is open, but they need to create more pressure. They need to establish their tactic that they had the first half, that it worked so well, that it kept Orcas completely out of their game. Right now, Orcas is reestablished their game, and if this is the case, then I don't see how it can be possible that Flipper scores, because Orcas are very good at defending, and they proved it yesterday in the match against Molde. So I don't know if it's a penalty. I would have thought that, because there was quite a kick in the face. But it's free throw. It's a free throw. Let's see. Free throw against Orcas. Let's see if Flipper can take advantage of this. So 8 minutes, 45 seconds to go. And they started the free throw, but it's going slow. Now we have the attacker of Flipper being blocked by one of the captain, but Samuel, he recovered the ball, and now the next Orca player is being tucked away by two Flipper, and the ball fell down, and that was the captain again recovering the ball, doing a great pass forward to the counter-attacker, and Orca is coming. We have now okay, the ball fell and the player had gone up already, and the Flipper was fast enough to recover the ball and started in counter attack. And now we are going towards Orcas, and they recover the ball again. They pass it, and now we have the defender leaving the position, trying to start a counter attack, passing it toward, or willing to pass it through the middle. Free throw against Orcas from the 3 meters line, and I think the ball was outside the game area.
Flipper really has to speed up its game now and raise the pressure on the Orca basket, because the time is ticking against them. 7 minutes, that's enough time to score, but the Orcas are very dangerous in counter-attacking, so we see the Flipper players waiting on the surface, and they start their waves coming down.
We are discussing here that because that kick in the face of Orcas, why wasn't a penalty? And in the chat they're saying, well, it wasn't strong enough, there was not a clear opportunity to score. Okay, but at least, and sorry to say that, I would have given 2 minutes to
yes,
the goalkeeper, because that was unsportly behavior. So, okay, 2 minutes and a free throw. But I think that they were too easy on him. And you know that I like Orcas, so I'm trying to be objective here.
So, okay, 6 minutes, 20 left in this game. Call from the referee, and try to give us a little bit of background noise again from the pool area, which indicates always the tension in the pool area. So it's a free throw against Flipper. Time is ticking.
Yeah, Adam, I agree with left. You. That he said in Germany we call that a goal danger situation, because it's a one versus one at the, but at least a 2 minutes. That was a clear kick in the face. Anyway, poor referees, we don't want to complain about them. It's very difficult to see
everything.
It was
not
everything.
Complaining, it was just a different point of view, but I think that the referee is doing a great job, like we said. So Flipper is in attack mode again. They're coming in two players from the close side. Call from the referee. It's the chief referee on the surface, it seems like.
5 minutes, 30 seconds.
Free throw against Flipper.
Okay. They apparently, they was giving 2 minutes. Yeah, I mean, sorry, I
we didn't
sorry.
See it. We didn't see it on
we
the
see it.
Surface camera.
Yeah.
But so Lorena, you're you made the wrong referee decision.
Why?
Without knowing what really happened, you made the right referee timeout again. So we have six minutes left in this second half. And the Flipper coach is prepping his players. It doesn't seem very happy. I think it's not it's not a play game. Yes, I know, Carl. We need a connection to the players' table. We did have the cameras, but we have problems with the cables through the hall, through the playing area. So we have a totally new system here, and we are lucky it works this way, the way it works. It's totally net-based now on a network system. And so next time we will surely have cameras and probably even headsets for the chief referees, step by step.
So yeah, Thomas. I missed. Normally, I look for that kind of situation, but I missed site. I trust you, and we are, you know, after 3 days, sometimes we're a little bit tired, and we cannot pay. We're missing something.
Five
so
minutes left in this game, Orca against Flipper, and as much as the plan of the supposed plan of Flipper worked out in the first half. Or the beginning of the first half,
No, we are not near the pool. We are in the bunker far away, so we don't get a sight or anything. We are like in the basement at the back corner of the pool. That's why we don't have a sight of the pool area.
So we have a counterattack from Flipper going for the Orca basket, and but stopped by the defense, by the forechecking, And now the orca, the flippers tried from the closed side, one player lying in front of the basket in the middle and one on the closed side, but they're looks like they're tackled away. And now the flipper player is waiting near the corner of the closed side to for his teammates to start the attack. 4 minutes left, and
yes, I know.
As much as Orca seemed confused in the beginning, now it seems
they
to be flipper.
Yes,
yeah, now it
yes.
seems to be flipper not being in
what
the game. Call from the referee is pointing to an Orca player. As far as I see, looks like a free throw against Flipper. Yep, free throw against Flipper. 3 minutes and 30 left.
All right.
The
so
clock is ticking and it's working in favor of
Orcas. Yeah.
Of Orcas.
1-0, and because of the angle of the sunlight, it's a little bit darker right now. But let's see. Orcas is doing their Colombian style of just swimming around the basket, you know, from one side to the other in half a circle. And this is a different tactic that most of the European teams do that are more with the ball distributor in the middle, passing the ball right and left.
And
the Colombians concentrate
they
and swimming a
keeping
lot.
Keeping the ball.
Yes.
They're get
very
out
flexible,
of the dangerous zones.
20.
Yeah. Not being attacked and being... yeah, now they lost the ball. And this is always a dangerous situation, losing the ball and... being the one to run behind the swim behind the ball.
Sí, Orcas está pudiendo realizar el juego de ellos, que es nadar, que es moverse, que es mantener el balón. Flipper está un poco como desconcentrado, no pueden realmente establecer una ola de ataque para generar presión y forzar una falta en la defensa de Orcas. Y si ayer Molde no lo logró con la presión que estaban haciendo, con este tipo de juego tampoco lo van a lograr los chicos de Flipper. Les quedan 2 minutos y al menos que Orcas haga una falla, una falta fatal, no sé. Yo creo que este juego va para Orcas, que fue también mi predicción.
Referee decision, referee call, free throw against the Orcas. And 1 minute 40 left. Clock is ticking in favor of Orcas. And Flipper should up their game and put more speed into their attacks, more aggressiveness.
That was missing. I mean, that the player to pass that ball on the Orca side was missing, and that counterattack would have been a nice one, but it was stopped by the Flipper. And now Orcas are building up a bit slower and go to the surface with the ball, trying to attack, pass it to the next one, swimming. 1 minute left, and I don't see how this game can be turned around by Flipper. Orcas now is swimming, they are doing the game, and then it's going to be complicated for Flipper to recover the ball.
40 seconds left in this game, and if the Orcas don't make a big mistake right now, that's it.
Yes, now Flipper is
in a counter-attack
from
the Flipper team.
We have the defender in position, we have the goalie in position, we have four checkers in position. They're
last chance for Flipper.
Fighting, taking the attacker, and there's a lot of pressure and confusion. I can't see where the ball is. I think they're fighting in the surface.
14 seconds, 10 seconds left. Flipper should throw in now everything they have. 5-3-2-1-0.
Okay, that's it. Third
it was
position goes for Orcas.
It was an interesting change in the game, because in the beginning I really had the impression Orcas were confused by the interrupting style to play by Flipper, but when they scored and from that point on, and especially in the second half, it looked like orcas adapted to this style of playing.
Or Flipper lost concentration and couldn't keep up with the tactic.
Probably after they scored, they catch the goal. But interesting and very well played.
On the chat they were saying that they hoped that Flipper could be able to keep that cool head, because apparently they can, you know, get a little bit worked up and then you lose concentration. And then the moment Orcas could do their game, then that was the moment that the game more or less was decided. And yes. After Molde, they made such a pressure yesterday. It was impossible to watch, and still they couldn't score. Flipper didn't even get close to provoke pressure at all in the basket. I mean,
no, it was a different game, and I think the Flipper counted on confusing Orcas and then scoring in the right moment, but imposing their style, their will on the game of Orcas, but they didn't succeed the whole game, especially after Orcas scored. Yes, Jörg.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you very much.
That would be a funny YouTube channel.
It will be.
Say
hilarious.
Something. Thank you.
Yeah, hilarious, hilarious. We will.
Okay, let's go back to the actual. Let's focus. The next game, Castor Sakharin.
Yes, this will
define. This is a money game, the money changing game. Who will be the champion of this tournament in a woman?
And I think that we will see two different styles in playing. Akarin is cooler in the play, like the building up of these waves.